Breaking tonight, a young life cut tragically short. Friends and family are mourning the loss of 15-year-old Kayla Rincon Miller.
She was shot and killed during an attempted robbery while she and her friends were walking from the movie theater to McDonald's. Thank you for watching NBC2. I'm Peter Bush.
And I'm Kyla Gaylor. NBC2's Samantha Romero is live near Southeast 20th Street and Southeast 16th Place, where she spoke to some of Kayla's friends. How are they doing tonight, Sam?
Well, three of Kayla Rincon Miller's closest friends told me they still can't believe that she's gone yet. They told me she would have turned 16 in just a couple of weeks, a sweet 16 party that she's been planning her entire life. But unfortunately, that is not happening. But they did tell me that Kayla was extremely funny. She loved music. She loved her friends and she loved her family. And tonight, a lot of her friends, family and community members created this makeshift memorial where they're gathering to remember Kayla. They left behind candles and flowers and stuffed animals to honor the life taken away way too soon.
Honestly, not good at all. I've been crying all day. Like, every time I even, like, think of her, I just, like, it's not real.
It's been 24 hours since Kayla Rincon Miller died from a gunshot wound to her chest.
Yeah, I did.
But for Kayla's friends, this reality still hasn't sunk in.
Like, I feel like I'm going to see her tomorrow, or she's going to call me.
Yeah, like, she's going to text us tonight and be like, oh, I'm fine, guys.
A routine since middle school, but this morning when Bailey Powell called Kayla's phone, it went unanswered.
I'm in denial right now.
Cape Coral police say Kayla and her two friends were walking from the Marquee Cinema to McDonald's less than a mile away. Then a silver car with four people inside stopped and tried to rob Kayla and her friends. One of the suspects shot Kayla in the chest and killed her.
Yeah, you need God. And what if that was your best friend, or what if that was your sister, you know, like.
Kayla's friends helped put this memorial together. They hope it grows with more flowers and pictures.
Literally been my best friend. I can't even imagine, like, everywhere together. Football games, track meets, sunsplash.
To Elise De Jesus, Kayla was like a little sister.
She was like my passenger princess. Like, she was always in my car. I would, like, go get my hair done. I'm like, hey, you just want to go for a ride? And we would just sit there, drive wherever, or sometimes just go to the gas station, like not even buy anything.
A kind soul who her friends say loved everyone, and that love doesn't go away overnight.
I just want her to know that everyone loves her. She's
so loved.
So loved, like incredibly.
The Cape Coral Police Department says that whoever killed Kayla is still out there. Now, if you know who was in the car or have surveillance video in this area, make sure to call CCPD or Crime Stoppers. I'm local in Cape Coral on Southeast 20th Street. Samantha Romero, NBC2.